Georgia won the toss. They have deferred, so they will kick off. Alabama electing to receive. Cannon Parkman, number 6, a senior from Stone Mountain, Georgia, will kick it off. Michael Fagan and Curtis Alexander are deep, and it's going to be Michael Fagan off his chest inside the 5, picked up by Alexander, and he'll be down right there. Hayden Stockton, a junior from Double Springs, Alabama, picking it off and dropping back for Georgia 23, Chris McCraney, standing about midfield. A good high hanger. McCraney has some blocking. Trying to get to the wall, he does. Inside the 25, and the punter Hayden Stockton brings him down. On third down, the option, Hines Ward trying to cut it up. The ball comes loose. Alabama thinks they've got it, and they do.
Alabama gets a break and gets it back. Good defense.
Just inside their own 30, Bergdorf on play action. Firing it out, completing to Tony Robinson, the tight end. And Alabama has not done a good job of converting on third down. This time Bergdorf has good protection, but nobody open. He has the first down as he slides down in Georgia territory near the 38, covered by Kirby Smart, the safety. And Alabama facing a second and 18 from the Georgia 45. No score in the first quarter. Little in motion. Bergdorf under pressure gets it away down the middle. Complete to Johnson and a first down inside the 15. Third down 10, Bergdorf out of the shotgun. Complete and busted out of bounds. Very close to a first down as Curtis Brown, Alanda Sims, the left corner, number 22, made the hit. Michael Proctor, who has made 4 out of 4 this year and 22 of his last 25, by going 21-yard distance, he bangs it right through there. 7:08 to go in the first quarter, and Bama on the board, leading 3-0. Play action. Hines Ward looking to throw. Intercepted, picked off by Kevin Jackson, the strong safety. I'll tell you what, those Virginia Hokies are doing it. Hayden Stockton punting it in and out of the end zone.
Keep in mind, Ray Goff told him, don't try and win the game by yourself. He's got to learn to let the defense take care of itself too here today.
Quarterback draw out of the shotgun. Hines Ward trying to use that ability. Picks up the first down as he gets across the 30. Second down. Bowie again. As a hole. Tripped up. And again, a good play by Kevin Jackson. Or Bowie might have had a whole lot more. Georgia at their own 40. Option. Bowie cutting it back. First down. To the 46. Hines is probably less nervous now. But you can see the frustration on his face. Dax Langley with a good high hanger. Michael Fagan calling for the fair catch. He takes it at the 14. And Glenn now the interim AD at Alabama, trying to help them through their problems. Flag goes down right at the line of scrimmage. The ball came out of the grasp of Curtis Alexander. But I believe that they have blown it dead.
Offense, half a distance, second down.
Final seconds of the first quarter. Alabama leading Georgia 3-0. Alexander, fumble. The ball out of bounds. They're going to mark it at about the 1-foot line or less. Did Georgia get possession? Chris McCraney, number 23, has dropped back for Georgia, standing at about the Alabama 45. Stockton, a high kick. And McCraney's going to let it roll at midfield.
That's a terrific kick for Alabama.
Outstanding as it rolls down near the Georgia 40. First and 10, Alabama leading 3-0. Early in the second quarter. Mary Bowie banging it straight ahead across the 45.
Shannon Brown, All-American defensive tackle, captain.
Bowie again, banging running straight ahead and running over people. And Jackson, who's been very busy, just grabbed on and held on.
They're going to let him go back and throw? They thought not.
Dax Langley punting. Michael Fagan back is going to let it bounce in the end zone for the touchback. Straight drop. Nobody open. The ball came out. Flag is down as well. Georgia thinks they got it, but it might have been Bergdorf who recovered his own fumble. Oh, Georgia does have it.
Face mask, defense, personal foul, 15 yards from the end of the run before the fumble.
Well, the punters have been busy and very important in this game. Hayden Stockman has been booming, and he's on again and hits another beauty. Chris McCraney back at the 20. Trying to get to the wall. Runs out of room. Certainly as long as Hines Ward remains a quarterback. On the option. Bowie picking his way through the defenders. And a penalty flag is down as Bowie gets to about the 32. Chris Hood, number 34, on the stop.
Lock in the back. Offense. Be 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Second down.
Well, I'll tell you what, both these teams, second and long, third and long, penalties, turnovers. Marseille Simpson, 43 into the game. And Hines Ward trying it again, fumbles the football. Picked up by Cedric Samuel. Touchdown, Alabama. Well, they've got two outstanding receivers in Bryce Hunter and Juan Daniels. But they're going to run on first down. And breaking it up smartly is Selma Callaway. From the shotgun. Looking long. And a flag goes down as the pass was intended for Matt Dixon.
Interference, defense, automatic first down.
So Lou Holtz said, if Ohio State jumps on them early, it could be a long afternoon.
Callaway with a big hole inside the Alabama 35. Bowie banging ahead for the first down inside the 30. Covered by Kevin Jackson.
Also has the world's biggest fire hydrant.
Bowie breaks a tackle in the backfield. Inside the 20. Inside the 10. Dragged down by Cedric Samuel, or he might have gone all the way. Cannon Parkman on to attempt a 27-yard field goal. He's 3 of 4. Well, this one isn't going to make it. Alabama's Deshae Townsend down the sidelines. Still on his feet. Townsend will go all the way.
There's the linebacker locks on. No question about it. I'm going to tell you something. He was wrapped up big time.
Dax Langley punting. And Michael Fagan's going to watch it roll down near the Alabama 20.
Hey, listen, we really would like your inspiration on the sideline. If you can do it, come on. He said, Coach, I'll be there.
Play action. Kitchens firing it over the middle and completing it. Chad Key still fighting. And finally hauled down at about the 35. Good second effort by Key. And they may just let this clock run down.
I think Ray Goff says, let's just get in and regroup in that locker room. Rather than using his last timeout and try to get the ball on a punt, he says, let's get in the locker room.
Well, it hadn't been a beauty. A lot of problems on both sides, but Alabama leads it 17 to nothing. Brian Smith back in at quarterback for Georgia, first and 10 from their own 20, trailing by 17. Larry Bowie, good hole. And Bowie dragging Brad Ford with him for a big gain on first down. Bowie again, breaking off tackle and getting the first down out to about the 34. Ralph Staten, number 41, on the stop for Bama. Down the middle and incomplete. Too tall. Juan Daniels will get a flag, however. Three flags came out. Deshae Townsend had the coverage as Brian Smith's pass was intended for Daniels. That is the 10th penalty on Alabama, but it is first and 10. Georgia now at their own 47. Smith under pressure. He won't go very far. Another flag is down. However, in the Georgia backfield, Ralph Staten finally making the tackle on Smith.
You've got good pressure. You already have the quarterback starting to scramble and try to make something positive. Then you grab his face mask.
Georgia is 2 of 4 on fourth down conversions this year. Smith over the middle. Is it complete?
Yes.
Good grab by Larry Brown, the tight end. Second down and 8. Georgia trying to get on the board. Got it to Chris McCraney. And McCraney driven out of bounds. Short of the first down at about the 15 by Brad Ford. Now it is 3rd and 1. Bowie, first down, inside the 10. And Georgia now has 1st and goal from the 8. Trailing 17-0. Bowie, down to the 2-yard line. About 2 feet to go, 4th down and goal. Power eye in the backfield. Kurtsey again, is he in there? He got hammered. He got hammered. Alabama and Deshae Townsend and John Walters have turned Georgia back. Chris McCraney, 23, has dropped back to the Alabama 45. And Stockton hits a beauty. McCraney at about the 48. Back to the 45, and that's it. Tracy High and Kelvin Sigler make the stop. A 45-yard punt. Dax Langley into punt. On 4th and 4, Deshae Townsend dropping back for Alabama. Langley trying to put it out inside the 5, and boy, does he at the 1-yard line. Dennis Riddle picking his way through, has a 1st down, and he's out to about the 15. 3rd down, 6. Bergdorf, oh, what a catch. Snagged right off the top of the grass from the shotgun. And it's complete to Chad Key. Well, the way Hayden Stockton's been punting, the extra 5 yards may mean nothing. He booms another one. Chris McCraney back at the 5. Cutting it back. Getting away again. Upfield to about the 17. Knocked down by Lamont Floyd, number 57. 1st and 10 at their own 18. Play action. Smith looking for somebody. Completes it to Juan Daniels. Daniels has a 1st down outside the 35. On 1st down, play action again. Intercepted. Picked off by Kevin Jackson, who's had a heck of a ball game for Alabama. Even though his team is leading 17-0, he knows they have not played that well. And these penalties have been totally out of hand. Stockton's punt to McCraney. And this time, McCraney lets it go.
Boy, Alabama coming off that loss to Arkansas has not lost back-to-back SEC games since 1990 and came in here today with a mission.
Smith looking to throw again. Incomplete.
Pass interference.
Intended for Hunter over the middle.
Pass interference. Defense. 1st down at the spot of the foul.
By and large, that's what's controlled the scoring and the field position. Complete to Hunter, and he has enough for the 1st down in the grasp of Brad Ford. And September 30th has been good to the Tide. Not lost on this date. Firing over the middle and complete. Bryce Hunter sliding down near midfield. He'll be about 3 or 4 yards short of the 1st down. Andre Short, number 23, was covering. Ugga. Now the Dogs need a little Ugga right now. Down 17-0 with less than 8 minutes to go. And they're going for it on 4th and 2. I don't think they're going to get it. Bowie, you know, averaging less than 4 yards a carry. Edwards was averaging over 7 yards a carry.
Yeah, he's the guy that actually was the top rusher in the SEC when he went out with that injury.
Dennis Riddle breaking a tackle inside the 30. Riddle cutting it back. He may go all the way. He will go all the way. Touchdown, Alabama.
Bring it back. It's going to be a clip against the Tide.
There's a flag at the 25-yard line. On first down, the reverse. Patrick Hayes coming around on the end around, the tight end. And let's check in with John Spagnuolo. Yep, they got a lot of guys coming back. Now it is fourth down and one. Riddle appears to have enough for the first down as he's near the 23 before he's thrown back by Greg Bright, number 45. Bama first and 10 at the Georgia 23. Riddle again. Squirting through and getting inside the 20 near the 18. Fourth down, 3 yards to go. Bama just going to keep pounding away. Riddle, good hole. He may have the first down. It's going to be close. Going to be close. He may be a little short depending on the spot. Jason Ferguson and Keith Drayton making the tackle.
Doesn't look like he's going to make it with that mark. So Georgia will take over on downs.
First and 10. Georgia takes over on downs at its own 15. Smith, fumble, and it looks like Alabama got it. The Tide recovers. Kitchens in a quarterback. Riddle getting to the corner. They got it blocked beautifully. Touchdown, Alabama. And this time, we do not see any flags. Less than 2 minutes to go. Brian Smith from the shotgun. Intercepted, picked off by Kevin Jackson. And Jackson may go all the way. He does. Alabama's defense puts a big exclamation point on this one. Well, Alabama among the most successful teams in the 90s, and certainly one of the most successful programs ever, if you want to go back to Bear Bryant and before.
No question about that, and of course that's listed by wins. Alabama, we talked about the penalty. That's the first time in their 102 years of football that they've ever been charged with anything.
Warren Kurtze thrown for a loss again, and Chris Hood, who's having a big game every time he's in there, it seems like he makes a big play. And this is a big win and their first shutout ever here in Athens. Clock continuing to run. Less than 30 seconds to go. Fernando Davis making the stop on Odell Collins. Now 15 seconds left.
There's Gene Stallings, country gentleman, solid football coach. He's 60 years of age now, the first year of a 5-year deal.
Well, it's also not only the first time Alabama has shut out Georgia here in Athens, it's the fourth biggest margin of victory ever for Alabama over Georgia. They beat them by 36 points a couple of times past, but 31 to nothing. And that number one defense in the SEC coming in, the Crimson Tide stop unit, really did the job today. And you can see how close Ray Goff and Gene Stallings are. As he told us in his office yesterday, Ray Goff saying, "Gene's been like a daddy to me. I hate playing him." Well, he hates playing him even more after today.